Hello, welcome. After numerous videos analyzing which is the best emulator to play Zelda Breath of the Wild, making graphic comparisons between the Wii U and Switch versions, it's time to answer the question that was missing. How does the game perform on Android? That's the answer you'll find in this video. But before we dive in, if you enjoy this type of content, don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe to the channel to stay updated with our game and emulation analyses and information.
This video is offered by the members and Patreons of the channel. Thank you for your support.
To my surprise, the game is playable on two of the three available apps on Android. The setup we're using here includes native resolution, portable mode, and turnip drivers for better performance, but it can also be used with the native Android driver. If you want to check out more games and how they perform on Android, I'll leave a card for you to watch after this video, where I test 5 different games and give my opinion on each app. Starting with Skyline Edge, I'm using version 69, which is the latest before development was cancelled. It's no surprise that the game didn't even start on my device. To this day, this emulator has had the lowest success rate, with the game simply crashing on startup, which doesn't allow me to show anything directly from Skyline. Moving on to Yuzu, it's important to note that the game requires quite high system requirements, such as 12 GB of RAM. My current device has only 8 GB of RAM and no virtual RAM, but that doesn't mean the game won't run. However, over time, it tends to slow down and disable some of the phone's features, like the user interface that shows FPS, CPU usage, and GPU usage. In my opinion, I believe that when all Yuzu recompilers are running natively on ARM, the app will have a significant performance boost. To briefly explain how some recompilers work in the current versions, the Nintendo Switch uses the ARM architecture, which is the same as current Android devices. The simplest way to translate Yuzu's instructions would be to convert Yuzu's ARM instructions to Android's. However, the current process involves translating the Switch's ARM instructions into Windows instructions, and then translating them into Android. This involves an additional process that consumes more Android resources. Finally, we have the best app on Android, Acess. Unlike Yuzu, in this app, we can run the game even with 8 GB of RAM, and the performance is impressive. When not compiling any shaders, it's easy to maintain a frame rate of 30 FPS on my device. Running the game at native resolution in portable mode, using only about 80% of the GPU's total load. As for bugs, I found very few, such as transparency and item names, but nothing that hinders gameplay. As for temperature, during the tests, my device reached close to 40 degrees Celsius. This measurement represents the internal temperature of the device, and not the CPU or GPU temperature. In general, my device can handle up to 42 degrees Celsius without a drop in performance, but a smartphone cooler would be useful in longer gaming sessions. This was my overall experience with Zelda Breath of the Wild on Android. Remember that if you have a Snapdragon Gen 2 device, you'll have even better performance. You'll find all the information about my device, as well as how this game performs on Windows, in the description. I hope you enjoyed the video, and until next time,